I'm Commander Wayne Lebold, the ship's executive officer. It is my privilege to be your master of ceremonies today. We are here today to celebrate the commissioning of USS Montgomery, the 6th U.S. Navy warship to bear that name, and the 8th in the class of the littoral combat ships. Littoral combat ships are unique in the Navy ship design. The primary mission of the LCS can be changed from surface warfare to anti-submarine warfare or mine warfare simply by changing out the mission module on the ship. The LCS is designed to operate in water too shallow for other Navy ship classes. This class also has a very large flight deck and blazing speed in excess of 40 knots. It truly is a revolutionary design. One of the most symbolic artifacts in Navy history is the ship's bell. Engraved with the ship's name and hull number, the bell notifies sailors of the arrival and departure of officers and dignitaries. It signals other ships while in fog at anchor. It raises the alarm in event of fire or flooding. It marks the passing of time and signals relief of the watch. It is an integral part of the ship's life, from arrival of a guest to the baptism of a child. This bell signaled the commissioning of USS Montgomery C-9, a ship that served in both the Spanish-American War and World War I, the first ship to carry the great name of the City of Dreams 122 years ago. She will again find her place on board the U.S. Navy's newest littoral combat ship, USS Montgomery, LCS-8, as she signals her commission and her maiden voyage to her home port of San Diego, California. Today, this historic bell serves as a tangible connection to our past, even as we sail into the future. The bell alone cannot ring. A stand of teak will connect her to her new ship. The teak is from the decks of the World War II battleship USS Alabama. It will also grace the bridge of this fine warship and be a visible reminder of the Navy's legacy. A legacy passed from generation to generation, which transcends any one individual here today. As the last sailor leaves this mighty warship decades from now and the bell sounds the end of her service, may they still feel the spirit of the sailors who've sailed before, and may that connection to our past never be broken. The ship before you was christened on November 8, 2014 at Austell Corporation here in Mobile, Alabama. Today she is complete and we are proud to serve in the newest warship in the United States Navy. The ship's crews are honored to carry the City of Montgomery's proud name as we defend the American way of life whenever and wherever we may be called. Our ceremony today is a time-honored tradition which began with the commission of our first ship, a captured British schooner, the Margareta, in 1775. Since then, thousands of ships have undergone the transformation from silent hull to fully alive warship. Our commissioning crew, hereafter known as plank owners, are in formation among you and ready. In just a few moments, the Navy Band Southeast and the Naval Station Norfolk Armory will render honors to the Honorable Jeff Sessions, United States Sailor, the Senator, State of Alabama. Ship's company, attend hut. Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of our official party, honors, and the invocation. Ladies and gentlemen, our platform guests, Bishop R. Lawson Bryan, Senior Pastor of the Montgomery United Methodist Church. Mr. Steve Jones, the USS Montgomery Commissioning Committee Chairman. The Honorable Elton Dean, Montgomery County Commission Chairman. The Honorable Todd Strange, Mayor, City of Montgomery, Alabama. Commander Mark Stefanik, United States Navy, Commanding Officer, LCS Crew 209. Captain Brian Lawrence, United States Navy, Executive Officer and Deputy for Operations, Supervisor of Shipbuilding, Gulf Coast. Captain Warren Buller II, United States Navy, Commander, Littoral Combat Ship Squadron 1. Captain Thomas Anderson, United States Navy, Littoral Combat Ship Program Manager. Mr. Craig Percivali, President, Austell, USA. Ms. Gloria Valdez, Deputy Assistant Secretary of the Navy Ships. Rear Admiral John Nagley, United States Navy, Program Executive Officer for Littoral Combat Ships. The Honorable Sandy Stimson, Mayor, City of Mobile, Alabama. Admiral William Moran, United States Navy, Vice Chief of Naval Operations. The Honorable Kay Ivey, Lieutenant Governor, State of Alabama. The Honorable Bradley Byrne, United States Representative, 1st District, State of Alabama. Ladies and gentlemen, our ship's sponsor, Ms. Mary Sessions, escorted today by Command Master Chief Michelle Ann Hastings. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Jeff Sessions, United States Senator, State of Alabama, escorted today by our commanding officer, Commander Daniel Straub, United States Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, honors for the Honorable Jeff Sessions, United States Senator, State of Alabama. Platform and salute. Ready, two. Advance the colors. Thank you. platform. Ready? Two. The C-130 flyby today was provided by the 988th Airlift Wing from Maxwell Air Force Base in Montgomery. The aircraft was the City of Montgomery 2 with the crest of Montgomery on the nose. A special thanks to Colonels Condit, Brooks, and Love from the wing for today's flyover. Ladies and gentlemen, Bishop Ryan will deliver the invocation.
Let us pray. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. When we look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, who are we that you are mindful of us, mortals that you care for us? Yet you have made us little less than God and crowned us with glory and honor. You have given us dominion over the works of your hands. We pray that we may be good stewards of all you have entrusted to our care. Especially today, O Lord, we remember the words of the psalmist. Some went down to the sea in ships, doing business on the mighty waters. They saw the deeds of the Lord, his wondrous works in the deep. We thank you for the creativity you have given to those who designed and those who constructed the USS Montgomery, whose launch we celebrate today. May they find great fulfillment in the knowledge that their labor has made possible this addition to the United States Navy. We praise you for the long history of our Navy. May this ship make a fresh contribution to the mission to protect and defend the right of the United States and our allies to move freely on the oceans and to secure our country against those who would do us harm. May all who live and serve in this ship be filled with a spirit of unity, always demonstrating support and encouragement toward one another. And now we lift our hearts in prayer for all of those who are represented by the Montgomery. May all of our citizens demonstrate in our lives the same values we recognize and celebrate in the launch of this ship today. Lord, this is our prayer, which we offer with gratitude and thanksgiving. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop Ryan. Will the guests please be seated? Ship's company, parade, rest. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Sandy Stimson, Mayor, City of Mobile, Alabama.
Good morning. To all of our guests, welcome. I think it's appropriate today, as I list our dignitaries, to say Mrs. and Senator Session. I think that would be proper protocol. But then we have Congressman Byrne, Lieutenant Governor Kay Ivey, General Moran, Gloria Valdez. Each one of you, in the eyes of Mobilian, are very special, especially those that are wearing the uniform of our military. Not long ago, in the city of Mobile, we went through a rebranding campaign, an effort. And what we realized was that we were born to celebrate. We are a city that has been celebrating for over 300 years. And I can think of no greater opportunity than today to celebrate. If you think back on the birth of whether it was a grandchild or a child, the excitement that was stirred in your spirit, in your heart, of what those opportunities were and what the future of that child may be. What you will see today is you will see this ship come to life. You will see it born. That is such a special deal. You'll hear many people today talk about the spirit of a ship. I think it's appropriate that everyone in the crowd realize the very first explorers that sailed into Mobile Bay dubbed it the Bay of the Holy Spirit. So how fitting is it that the USS Montgomery will be sailing through the Bay of the Holy Spirit? Mayor Strange, I just want to compliment you and everybody from Montgomery for what you've done to make this such a momentous occasion. And I also want to thank all the workers and their leadership at Austell for what you've done. But in his absence, I would say we also want to thank the Secretary of the Navy, Ray Mavis, for his support of this. We hope each one of you enjoy yourself. And as I said, we're all here to celebrate. We are born to celebrate. Thank you very much and welcome to Mobile.
Thank you, Mayor Stimson. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Todd Strange, Mayor, City of Mobile. Joining him will be the County Commission Chairman, Eldon Dean.
Well, good morning. 3.5 years ago when Secretary Mavis called us and said, we'd like to name a ship, the USS Montgomery, little did we know what was involved in that. Admiral Clyde Marsh might have known from Montgomery, but we didn't have a clue. But what we knew is we owed a debt of gratitude, not only to the Navy, but to the great company that's building this and to our community that stood behind this. Last night, when we had the ringing of the bell by the commander of this great warship, the announcement was Montgomery is in port. Not the city of, not the county of, but Montgomery is in port. With me is the chairman of the Montgomery County Commission. I'd like for him to bring greetings and also to give thanks for the great job that's being done.
Good morning. I would like for Commissioner Walker, Hall, and Harris to please stand while I make these comments. Commissioner Hall, these are my teammates on the Montgomery County Commission. And on behalf of the 230,000 citizens that we represent in the city and county of Montgomery, we want to thank you to the new U.S. Navy, to the Honorable Jeff Sessions, and Madam Sessions, will you please come up here, please? I want to give you a great, great, great Montgomery hug. Thank you.
Well, with equal time, with the Montgomery County City Council, please stand. This is the group, along with the County Commission and many of you in the audience, that are making this particular possible. Now, let's do one other thing. You guys stay standing. All Montgomeryans, all that want to be Montgomeryans, would you please stand and show the great show of force that we have here? This is Montgomery, ladies and gentlemen. We got two Air Force generals, one the head of Air University, here to talk, to show the jointness. We understand jointness, and we know as an Air Force town in Montgomery, we can't do it all, but we can join together to be able to do this. I want to make sure that you know that in those tents over there, after this is over, a Montgomery tradition is on site. Chris's hot dogs, 2,500 hot dogs are over there waiting to be eaten, and some Coca-Cola products are over there waiting to be drunk. So please make your way over, not to the reception, but just a good time to get out of this particular heat. Let me close by simply saying this. We are so honored, and it's not lost on me, that we are on the eve of the 15th anniversary of the tragedy of 9/11. And this ship will stand as an example to the world, the might and the strength and the resolve of the United States of America to not let 9/11 stand. As it travels the waters of this world, as it goes into the ports, back of the ship says Montgomery, with all its power, all its prestige, and it's all its honor to make the United States of America the best that we can be. God bless and thank each and every one of you for being here.
Thank you, Mayor Stimson. Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Mayor Strange. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Craig Percivali, President, Austell USA.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm truly honored to represent Austell USA and the rest of the industry team on this fine Navy day as we commission USS Montgomery. What's even more special is we're commissioning a ship whose namesake is our state capital and whose sponsor is the lovely Mary Sessions. What a fantastic day. It doesn't seem that long ago when we commissioned our first LCS, the USS Independence. But it was actually in January of 2010. Back then, Austell USA was about half the size it is today, with about 800 total employees. Today, we have a $400 million state-of-the-art manufacturing facility with over 4,000 of the best shipbuilding professionals in the country, making Austell USA the fifth largest shipyard in the country and the largest aluminum shipbuilder in the world. We're in full rate production, building expeditionary fast transports and littoral combat ships. Programs providing hope and opportunity for so many, and strengthening the Gulf Coast shipbuilding industrial base, which is so vital to our nation's long-term prosperity. Admiral Moran, Ms. Valdez, we thank you for the Navy's confidence in our ships, and we'll keep building on that confidence as we continue supporting these important programs and transition to frigate well into the future. Montgomery is our fourth LCS, and she's our best ship yet, able to reach speeds in excess of 40 knots while sporting the largest flight deck and mission bay of any surface combatant in the Navy. Montgomery is a revolutionary and cost-effective new warship with cutting-edge technology, bringing an unprecedented level of speed, volume, flexibility, and firepower to our combatant commanders now and for decades to come. So many incredible people have helped bring Montgomery to life. Admiral Nagley, Captain Anderson, Captain Toot, we greatly appreciate the leadership and support from you and your teams, as it's been crucial to this program's success. Support from our good friends, Senator Sessions, Senator Shelby, and Congressman Byrne, as well as the state of Alabama, Mayor Stimson, and the city and county of Mobile. The support has been amazing as well. Truly a strong public-private partnership others are trying to emulate. Our partners at General Dynamics Mission Systems, as well as hundreds of suppliers across 37 states, including over 400 across the state of Alabama that have supported our operations over the years, provide the best products and services critical to bringing Montgomery and her sister ships to life. Then there are the shipbuilding professionals at Austell USA, the best in the country, an incredible group of men and women committed to safely providing the most cost-effective and capable ships to our great Navy. But it doesn't stop there. There are the families and the friends of those that work with us who support them as well. Heck, you'd be hard pressed not to find someone who either works at Austell USA or who has a family member or friend that do. I was just talking to my son the other day, Connor, who's here with me. And he said, it's amazing how you can't drive more than 2 minutes and not find an Austell parking pass hanging from the rearview mirror of cars you're driving around. This is a community effort that's helping make this happen. And it's truly that support that will help carry us well into the future. Commander Straub, the hearts of incredible people went into building this great warship. We know she will serve you well as you take her across the globe to defend our freedom. We thank you and your crew for your service to our country, and we wish you fair winds and following seas. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what America is all about. Incredible people pulling together to build the USS Montgomery, the coolest ship on the planet, built for the greatest Navy on the planet, right here in the great state of Alabama. It just doesn't get any better than this. God bless the USS Montgomery, all who sail in her, and God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Percy Avali. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Gloria Valdez, Deputy Assistant Secretary of the Navy, ships.
Good morning, everyone. Senator and Mrs. Sessions, Secretary Winter and Mrs. Winter, Honorable Byrne, Lieutenant Governor Ivey, Admiral Moran, distinguished platform guests, officers and crew of the Montgomery, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm delighted to be here this morning representing Secretary of the Navy Ray Mabus at the commissioning of the great littoral combat ship Montgomery. We celebrate today in Mobile, before this magnificent ship on the eve of September 11. And while we remember the tragedy of that sad day in 2001, we celebrate the American spirit. That spirit is clearly embodied in this fine ship, Montgomery. I would like to also remember and say thank you to the thousands of sailors, Marines, airmen, and their families, soldiers across the world sacrificing so much to keep this nation free. And to those veterans in the audience today, thank you for your service to our nation. I would like to recognize and thank Society of Sponsors President Linda Winter for your tireless efforts in organizing the distinguished ladies who have taken part in our time-honored tradition of sponsoring naval ships, including the Montgomery. Sponsors play a unique role for the Navy. They become a part of each ship's history. While the crew of the ship may change many times over the course of its life, the sponsor remains the same. I would also like to thank Mr. Steve Jones and the entire Montgomery Commissioning Committee who have worked so hard to arrange both last night's and today's commissioning event, which appropriately marks the transition of a ship from construction to that of a powerful fleet asset, ready and well equipped to defend our nation's freedoms around the world. To the Navy and industry shipbuilding team, you have labored tirelessly to deliver this extraordinarily capable ship. You have proven that hard work, perseverance, and above all, teamwork produce outstanding results. Thank you and congratulations on a job well done. Today, we also honor and congratulate the ship's crew and the men and women of Austal Marine for constructing this magnificent ship. Montgomery is a shining example of our nation's drive for excellence and honors the memory of the ship and the crews who proudly served our nation under the namesake Montgomery previously. As we commission this newest USS Montgomery today, we continue this proud tradition. Commander Strong, thank you for your hard work that has culminated in today's milestone based upon your proven leadership. Your nation has entrusted with you our newest and finest warship and charged you with preparing your crew for sea. Taking Montgomery around the world, building partnerships, protecting our interests, answering the call. What an awesome task. I am confident in you and your crew are ready for the challenge. You will have the unwavering support of your sponsor and your namesake city. Officers and crew of Montgomery, as you bring your ship to life today, you are blessed with a wonderful sponsor, Mrs. Mary Session. She has bestowed you with grace and responsibility. Take heed. Serve honorably and protect the seas. And to all of you who are present today, we are indeed privileged to witness the introduction of this fine ship into our Navy. May God bless her, our crew, her sponsor, and may God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Valdez. Ladies and gentlemen, Rear Admiral John Nagley, Program Executive Officer, Littoral Combat Ships.
Well, good morning and welcome. Today we gather here to engage in one of the most time-honored naval traditions, the commissioning of a new warship, USS Montgomery, LCSA. Senator Sessions, Mrs. Sessions, Congressman Byrne, honored and distinguished guests, and the great shipbuilders of Austell and our entire LCS industry team, welcome and thank you for continuing to support our Navy. I'd like to specially recognize Mrs. Sessions as the ship sponsor for all of her dedicated efforts in supporting the crew and the families of Montgomery. You have really left a mark on that crew that will carry with her through the life of the ship. I also want to especially thank Montgomery's Commission Committee who have tirelessly worked to plan the great ceremony today. The pride of your city, your passion for our country, and our great Navy is reflected in every aspect of this ceremony. Thank you for the extra effort you put into making this event so special. Shipbuilding has always been part of our nation's history. From the first six frigates to the USS Montgomery today, shipbuilding is in the nation's blood. There is no prouder profession or more important work to be done. And there is no better shipbuilding team than the team assembled here in Mobile, Alabama. Greg, thank you for the great work from your team and work being such a wonderful partner for us as we deliver these magnificent warships to the fleet. USS Montgomery is the second warship to be named after the capital city of Alabama. We'll enter the fleet at a critical time as the Navy continues to rebalance the Pacific. I expect this ship will forge an enduring legacy in coming years. It'll represent U.S. interests far and wide. She is a proven warship, a ship designed to ensure our preeminence and sea control, a ship that'll help us build and engage in partnerships with our friends across the globe, and a ship that provides tremendous amount of flexibility and firepower to our combatant commanders in an ever-changing security environment. I am more than ever convinced that LCS and the USS Montgomery is the right ship at the right place at the right time. Commander Straub, Commander Stefanik, congratulations to you and your crew as Montgomery officially enters the fleet today. I know you will forge new traditions and embark upon many new missions and challenges ahead. It'll be an exciting ride. But remember, the real combat power from any ship comes from America's best and brightest, the incredible men and women who man and fight her every day. And I know under your leadership, Montgomery and her crew will no doubt make her mark on the fleet. God bless, Godspeed, and thank you.
Thank you, Admiral Nagley. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Jeff Sessions, United States Senator, State of Alabama.
Thank you all. It is fabulous to be in hometown Mobile, Sandy, and see all the great progress, that skyline, this great ship behind us, and the great Austell shipyard across the river. It's a special day for Austell, the Navy, our Defense Department, for the United States of America, for Mobile, Alabama, and the whole state, and a very special day indeed for our capital city, Todd, Montgomery, Alabama. And I have to say, a very special day for the ship sponsor, my wife, Mary Sessions. I want to thank our outstanding Secretary of the Navy, our Mississippi neighbor, Ray Mavis. I want to thank him for naming this ship and choosing its sponsor, and especially friends and neighbors for his unwavering support for this LCS program. He has truly been a warrior, as Congressman Byrne knows, for this ship, its mission, its priority for the United States Navy, and we need to remember and celebrate that. The LCS Montgomery is a magnificent warship and a critically important addition to our Navy and our fleet. It projects power, it has speed, and it is and presents presence. It is a fast, economical, to build, economical, to operate warship, flexible in its capabilities, and can operate worldwide and in shallow waters. And please note that Austal is producing this ship below the cost cap, and the Montgomery is earning a clean sweep on its latest efficiency ratings, completing all of its trials, passing all of its tests. This success is a direct result of the fabulous 4,000 workers here at Austal. And on behalf of the people of Alabama and America, I want to thank you for that great work. We also need to remember that Austal is the largest employer in our community. So you workers at Austal have produced one of the most technologically advanced ships in the entire world. Bradley and I, and our whole delegation, the Alabama delegation, Senator Shelby and our members of Congress, fully understand the value of this ship to America. We totally support Secretary Mavis and the Navy and their vision, and we work every day to keep it on track, and we will continue to do so. Our Navy ship count now has fallen to 276 ships, while the Navy and defense experts say at a minimum we need 308. We need more than that, but we will never meet that goal without the full complement of the LCS ships. Many thanks to the support from Mayor Todd Strange of Montgomery for this ceremony, and Commission Chairman Elton Dean, the great wow party we had last night. Their fantastic support has been special. Finally and personally, I am so proud that my wife, Mary Montgomery Blackshear Sessions is her name, daughter of the sainted Eloise Montgomery, is this ship's sponsor. She's a native of Montgomery, born in Montgomery. We met at Huntington College in Montgomery. She is the best thing that's ever happened in my life. And it's a special day for her, and I want to congratulate her on this day. Our daughter and Navy spouse, Mary Abigail Reinhart, is here. Our daughter Ruth Walk and her husband John are here. My son Sam and his wife Angela are all here, all back home, with their 10 children, our 10 grandchildren, the oldest of which is 9. Our oldest, I'm proud to say, grandchild, is the maid of honor for this ship. Congratulations, Jane Ritchie. You've done a great job on this. Her father is the commanding officer of the USS Alabama, the nuclear submarine stationed in Washington State. So congratulations to Commander Daniel Straub, Commander Mark Stefanik, and your crews for your great work. We wish you fair winds and following seas. God bless you all.
Thank you, Senator Sessions. Ladies and gentlemen, Admiral William Moran, United States Navy, Vice Chief of Naval Operations.
Well, good morning, everybody. Great to be here. In Washington, D.C., we call this a great Navy day. And I'm looking out in the crowd here, and I'm seeing people burning up. And you all know we've got 15 more speakers to go, so I'm going to shorten my remarks because my sole responsibility today is to introduce your congressman in the 1st District of this great state of Alabama. But I do want to say just a couple things. Last night, the commissioning crew that helped sponsor just a wonderful event, the thing that was most clear to me throughout the entire evening was the warm, rich embrace that the city of Montgomery and the great city of Mobile have had for these two crews behind us in this wonderful ship that's going to honor this state and the city of Montgomery for the next several decades. So my thanks to everybody involved in that. You have made the Navy feel at home. You've made us feel part of your family, and the crew, every member back there standing about to man the rails to bring this ship to life thanks you as well. So, on behalf of the Secretary of the Navy and the Chief of Naval Operations, thank you to Mobile, to the citizens of Mobile, the citizens of Montgomery, and of course the great shipyard workers here in Oslo, our sailors and our Navy civilians, our engineers who have put this ship together over the last couple years, and especially the last few months as we've brought it together. So now I am privileged to introduce Mobile's hometown congressman, Representative Bradley Byrne of Alabama's 1st District, a lifelong resident of the Gulf Coast. He's no stranger to this town and this shipyard. Congressman Byrne was born and raised in Mobile, and he has dedicated much of his career serving the people of Alabama. He has served as a member of the Alabama State School Board, the Alabama State Senate, as Chancellor of Alabama's Community College System. In 2013, he was elected to the House of Representatives. And while we only met briefly this morning, I can already see in his eyes and in his heart, he is a stalwart supporter of the United States Navy and will continue to be into the future. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Congressman Bradley Byrne.
Thank you to Admiral Moran for that kind introduction, but more importantly, thank you, sir, for your service to our country. I've got great news for everybody. I am the last speaker. It's great to be here with my great friend and colleague, Senator Jeff Sessions, to be with my former colleague from Montgomery, Lieutenant Governor Kay Ivey, to be with two of the greatest mayors in the United States of America, Mayor Todd Strange from Montgomery and Mayor Sandy Stimson from Mobile. And especially, I'm proud to be here with Mary Sessions, the sponsor of this great ship. Her spirit will be in this ship for its entire life. And it's a great honor for you, but it's also a great honor for us to have your spirit in that ship. Thank you, Mary. I want to mention one thing about Montgomery, very special to me. When Mayor Strange asked everybody here to stand up that is from Montgomery or wants to be from Montgomery, my wife Rebecca stood up. Because I went to Montgomery, like Senator Sessions did, and found a great woman. And through her eyes and knowing her friends and family there in Montgomery, I learned personally what a great city and what a great community Montgomery is. And it's not just because you have Maxwell Air Force Base there, but people in Montgomery are strongly patriotic. You love your country. And it's so special that we have so many of you here today as we commission a ship named after your great city. Thank you for being here. I believe you will find the ship that bears your name will live up to the reputation you have established over the years. The Littoral Combat Ship Program here at Austin Shipyard, as you just heard, employs over 4,000 people in direct jobs. It started out at 800 people, as Craig said, not too long ago. Austin has worked with more than 550 suppliers in Alabama over the life of the program and 1,500 suppliers across 41 different states. But I'm not a supporter of this ship just because it's built here in Alabama, although I am very proud that it is. I'm a supporter of this ship because it is a critical part of the future of our fleet. As Senator Sessions said, our fleet has shrunk to 276 ships. And in just a few moments, it's going to grow to 277. The Navy knows that the minimum we need is 308. But studies and the work we've done in the Armed Services Committee in the House has said that we need 350. We don't get to 308, much less 350, if we do not build the full complement of littoral combat ships, including 26 to be built here in Mobile. So some people say, why do you fight so hard for these ships? Is it just because they build them in your home? I say, no, that's a good reason. I'm for these ships because these ships are critical to carrying out the mission of the United States Navy. The United States Navy projects force and deters aggression against our country. Just think about what's happened in recent days. Many of the sorties that have flown into Syria and Iraq are flown by jets off of United States Navy aircraft carriers into Syria and Iraq. Our Navy is performing an incredibly important function right now in the South China Sea. China says the South China Sea belongs to it. Over $5 trillion in trade flows through the South China Sea. Over half the world's population lives there. If China gets control of the South China Sea, we all lose. And the only way to push back against China as it seeks to do that is by having a strong and determined United States Navy. In just the past few days, the Iranian Navy has tried to harass U.S. Navy ships in the Straits of Hormuz. Well, I want the Iranian Navy to have that same feeling each one of us just had when those shots were fired off, that little nervousness in the pit of your stomach, every time they see a United States Navy ship come up. And I predict pretty soon they'll see ships like this, and I guarantee you, they'll have that nervousness in the pit of their stomach. And our good friends from Russia, who've now decided to go back to the bad old days, we now find their Navy in places that they haven't been in decades. The only way to step back against Russia is to have a strong and determined United States Navy. It's not just our military actions. Our Navy responds to disasters all over the world. 80% of the world's population lives within 60 miles of the sea. So just think about it. The recent tsunamis in Japan and Indonesia, the earthquake in Haiti, the search and rescue following the crash of the Air Asia flight. Who responded to that? The United States Navy. We also keep the sea lanes of the world open, not just in the South China Sea, but over the entire world. 90% of world trade goes by sea. $9 trillion is traded by sea each year. 40 million jobs in the United States are connected to sea trade. 95%, listen to this, 95% of all voice and data are being transferred under the ocean by cable, not up in the air. And it wouldn't take much for the Russians to go down there with these special little submarines they've got to clip those cables. Let me tell you something, you want to bring a lot of our daily lives to a real quick stop? Cut those cables. Who pushes back against that? The United States Navy. Just a couple of months ago, I got to go to the RIMPAC naval exercise. It's the largest naval exercise in the world. The United States Navy leads it. 25 other countries were participating. I got to see the awesomeness of our Navy cooperating with all these other navies. I got to go out on the USS Stennis, an aircraft carrier. Folks, if you want to understand the power of the United States, go on an aircraft carrier. The average age of a United States aircraft carrier, of the seaman, is 23. The average age on the flight deck is 21. And yet day after day after day after day, they are launching jets and recovering jets flawlessly. Day and night, good weather, bad weather, weekends and holidays. And those young sailors continue to do the job that you and I expect them to do without fail. And every time I meet those sailors, just like these sailors back here, it makes me proud. I also got to go on the sister ship to the Montgomery that we're going to commission in a moment here. Got to go on it at sea, flew on a helicopter, came in the stern you see here, landed on it, spent several hours, I and eight other members of Congress. Got to go all over the ship and up on the bridge, and they took it up to 38 knots. Now folks, the top speed of these ships is classified. I can't tell you how fast they go. But in South Alabama parlance, I can make you understand. They go real fast. You can barefoot ski behind one of these things. They let me drive it. They turn real quick. Now, a couple of things came out of that. The commander of the Pacific Command is a man named Admiral Harry Harris, Barry Prescott. He said, Congressman, when I was a young Navy officer during the Cold War, we had to be worried about the Soviet Union's corvettes, these small little ships that they had, they put missiles on. We had to be worried about, where are they? Well, now I get to have these littoral combat ships that I can put in different places around the Pacific with these Harpoon missiles on them, and now the Chinese Navy's got to worry, where are they? I want them to be worried about where these are. I also got to see the CRAM system that we put on. The CRAM is the missile defense on it.
Now here's the secret behind missile defense. You don't want a missile to hit your ship. So the CRAM detects the missile in the air and then shoots a projectile at it and explodes in the air. So the missile never gets to the ship. So the commander of the ship was telling us about that, and one of the congressmen with me turned to him and said, yeah, but what about a torpedo? He got a big smile on his face, and he said, oh, I can outrun a torpedo. That's quite a ship. When I returned back home after that Navy exercise, and I went to sleep, put my head on my pillow, and went to sleep soundly, like you and I do every night, I got to do that because the United States Navy is patrolling the waters of the world, keeping you and me safe. And making this ship and her sister ships is a very important part of the United States Navy carrying out that mission to keep you and me safe and keep you and me free. So, I make no apologies at all about the efforts that Senator Sessions, Senator Shelby, and so many other people in Congress are making to make sure that we keep building these ships for years and years to come. To Commander Straw and all those who will serve on this fine ship, I wish you fair winds and following seas. God bless you. God bless the great shipyard workers at Austal Shipyard that made this ship. And God bless the United States of America.
Thank you, Congressman Byrne. Admiral Moran, I would be honored if you would place Montgomery in commission.
On behalf of the Secretary of the Navy and for the President of the United States, I hereby place United States ship Montgomery in commission. May God bless and guide this warship and all who sail in her into the future.
Thank you, Admiral Moran. Executive Officer, hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant.
Aye, sir. Montgomery, attend, hut. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. I direct your attention to the ship's mast as we hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant. Quartermaster, hoist the colors and the commissioning pennant.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, the colors and commissioning pennant are flying over USS Montgomery.
Very well.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
I will now read my orders. From Chief of Naval Personnel to Commander Daniel Straub, United States Navy, Bureau of Personnel, Orders number 2584 of 15 September 2014. When directed, detach FFG 61 Ingraham and proceed to pre-commissioning Unit Montgomery for duties in conjunction with fitting out. Upon commissioning of USS Montgomery, report for duty as commanding officer. Admiral Moran, USS Montgomery is in commission and I am in command. Executive Officer, set the watch.
Aye, sir.
Pan left for them when they come up.
Officer of the deck, set the first watch.
Aye, sir.
The officer of the deck is the commanding officer's direct representative and while on watch is responsible for the safety and smooth operation of the ship and her crew. The long glass is the traditional symbol of an officer of the deck's authority in a ship of the line. We're honored today to have Mr. Steve Jones, our commissioning committee chairman, to assist in setting our first watch. He will pass our ship's long glass to our first officer of the deck, Lieutenant Anna Marie Gonzalez of Port Royal, South Carolina. The Petty Officer of the Watch is Operational Specialist First Class Cindy Negretti of Saigon, Vietnam. The Messenger of the Watch is Hull Technician Second Class Samuel Cunningham of Globe, Arizona. And the Bosun's Mate of the Watch is Chief Bosun's Mate Jericho Tracy of Manila, the Philippines.
Set the watch. On deck, section one.
Sir, the watch is set.
Very well. Captain, the watch is set.
Very well. Executive Officer, strike eight bells to signify the return of a warship named Montgomery to the fleet.
Aye, sir. Officer of the deck, strike eight bells.
Aye, sir.
We are delighted to have our sponsor, Mrs. Mary Sessions, with us here today. Mrs. Sessions christened this ship in Mobile, Alabama on November 8, 2014. Mary, I would be honored if you would join me and give the order to man our ship and bring her to life.
Of the USS Montgomery, man our ship and bring her to life.
Aye, sir.
Montgomery salutes you. We are proud to serve in your great Navy. Ready?
Two.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Captain, USS Montgomery is manned and ready.
Very well. Commodore Buller, USS Montgomery is manned and ready and reports for duty. Admiral Moran, request permission to break your flag. Executive Officer, break the flag of the Vice Chief of Naval Operations.
Aye, sir. Quartermaster, break the flag of the Vice Chief of Naval Operations.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, the flag of the Vice Chief of Naval Operations is flying over USS Montgomery.
Very well.
Ladies and gentlemen, Commander Daniel Straub, commanding officer, United States Ship Montgomery, LCSA.
Good morning, Senator Sessions, Senator and Mrs. Sessions, Congressman Byrne, Secretary Valdez, Secretary Winter, Mayor Strange and Mayor Stimson, Admirals Moran and Magley, fellow captains, distinguished guests, friends, family. You have heard how amazing this ship is. You have heard about the legacy of service by Alabamians and the historical nexus between the city of Montgomery, World War II battleship Alabama BB-60, the Teak and the Bell from the first USS Montgomery, named after the city in 1894. What you have not yet heard about is my incredibly talented crew who will operate this warship in service to our nation. Each of the sailors you saw enthusiastically running aboard has spent years of training to be here. Moreover, my crew has spent the last 6 months here in Mobile training, qualifying, and certifying for our time on board USS Montgomery. They are prepared. They are ready. There is no better crew in the world than the men and women you see here today preparing to take the Navy's newest and best warship over the horizon. Please, may I have a quick round of applause for your extraordinary USS Montgomery crew. I believe the personal freedoms, respect for human dignity, and economic prosperity we enjoy in the United States are unique throughout the history of mankind and across the span of the globe. I believe that this is not a natural state, but one which must be worked for relentlessly and, if necessary, defended. I believe the men and women who sallied forth from these very piers in ships like Battleship Alabama, BB-60, and the minesweepers, and more than 20 Liberty ships built here during World War II, were engaged in an honorable and worthwhile endeavor. I believe those deployed, eternally deployed, in defense of our nation's freedom did not die in vain. The future depends upon those willing to continue that honorable and worthwhile endeavor. And I would be remiss if I did not mention those who perished that warm September day 15 years ago simply because they were American. Accordingly, I reaffirm my vow to defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. Thank you, Mom, for being here today. I'm very glad you made the trip for this special occasion. To my sons, you inspire me through everything you do. And the men you have become. To my wife, thank you for your never-wavering love and support for more than 30 years, and for always being at my side on this adventure. Thank you. Shipmates of Montgomery, I will be proud to sail with you. Thank you.
Will the guests please rise? Bishop Ryan will now lead us in the benediction.
Let us pray. Grant us your blessing, O Lord, that what we have done here today will not end with this ceremony, but will be deepened in each of our lives like seed planted in good soil. Bring forth in us, indeed, bring us to life so that we may live to your glory and for the good of our citizens. And now unto him who by the power at work in us is able to accomplish far more than we could ask or imagine, to the only wise God be glory and authority this day and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop Ryan.